Vectors. Vectors are basically a part of mathematics, and mathematics is language of physics. In physics, we have to study mathematics, especially algebra, trigonometry, geometry, vectors, and then calculus. The first three parts, that is algebra, trigonometry, and geometry, as you have covered in your previous classes, but now we will cover the vector part and later on calculus part. So, vector. In vector, first thing is physical quantity. Physical quantity. Now, any quantity that can be expressed in numbers or can be measured in units is known as physical quantities. Physical quantities are also known as mathematical objects. We have two types of physical quantities. First is scalar and second one is vector. Now, scalar are those physical quantities which have only magnitude but they don't have any direction. For example, number of apples in a basket, number of pen lines on a table, or time, mass, length, volume. So scalar quantities, the quantities that have only magnitude but no direction. For example, in terms of physical quantities, we have time, length, mass, volume, density, temperature, and so on. But in vector quantities, we have magnitude. That is, for vector quantities, magnitude as well as direction is necessary. Now, why we need vectors? Now, suppose you have to visit your current position here, that is at point O, and you have to visit your friend's house, and your friend tell you that his house is 5 km away from this point, that is from the position O. Now, without knowing direction, you can't reach your destination, because 5 km can be anywhere, that is 5 km, a radius of 5 km, and the destination can be anywhere on this circle. So we need magnitude, that is 5 km, plus a direction so that we can reach our destination. Means if home is at point A, then we need a specific direction, that is in which direction we have to move. So vectors are those quantities we have which have magnitude as well as direction. But it does not mean that every quantity that have magnitude and direction are vector quantities. For example, we have some quantities that have magnitude as well as direction, but those quantities are scalar, those quantities are not vector. For example, time. Time have a particular direction. Time always flow from past to present and from present to future. So time has a magnitude as well as a direction, but still time is a scalar quantity. Second example is heat. Heat always flow from high temperature to low temperature. So in conventional term, heat have a magnitude as well as a direction, but still heat is a scalar quantity. One more example, that is electric current. Current always flow from high potential, that is high voltage, to low voltage or low potential, but still current is a scalar quantity. So for vector quantities, we have the basic condition is magnitude as well as direction plus the most important thing, and that is those quantities should follow vector law of addition, or also known as triangle law of addition, or also known as parallelogram law of addition. We will study it later on. For now, you have to remember that for a vector quantity, magnitude, direction, and most important, that is triangle law of addition or parallelogram law of addition, or it is also known as, they both combine in combined form known as vector law of addition. Now, example of vector quantities are displacement, velocity, force, field, and so on. Now, our main question is vector. So, representation of vector. How to represent a vector in notation and in geometrical form? That is representation of a vector. There are two ways to represent a vector. First, a vector can be written in bold letter, such as the letter can be capital as well as small. So first way to represent a vector, that is represent it in bold letter. Second one is with a light letter with an arrowhead. Now in text it is simple to write bold letter, but in conventional writing the much simpler is second one. So we will use this format here. Second thing, magnitude of a vector. Magnitude, or it is also known as modulus, or also known as amplitude. These three terms are basically one. So magnitude, modulus, or amplitude of a vector can be represented as either in this way or simply in a light letter without an arrowhead, or again bold letter inside the magnitude. These three ways, magnitude, modulus, amplitude, actually same thing. We have three ways to represent the magnitude or modulus or amplitude of a vector. In geometrical form, if we have to represent a vector, then in geometrical form, a vector is represented by a line segment. The point from where vector is starting is known as initial point. That is point O is known as initial point, or we can say that tail of the vector, and the point where vector is going to end, that is P, is known as terminal point, or also known as head of the vector, or also known as tip of the vector. The initial point is also known as origin of the vector. Now since vector is a vector have a direction as well, so direction is represented by in this way. There are two ways to represent a direction. Either we can represent vector as shown here or at the end of vector. The more used term is second one. So here OP, the length of line segment OP, that is length of OP represents magnitude of vector. If length of this line segment OP is more, it means magnitude is large, and if length of this line segment is short, then magnitude of vector OP is small. Now suppose this is vector A then vector A can be written as O P. Now this line segment give a sense of direction, that is from O to P. So O is also known as terminal point, initial point, tail or origin. P is known as terminal point, head or tip. Next comes some basic definition of vector, and the first one is co-initial vectors. Co-initial vectors. As the name suggests itself, co-initial vectors means the vectors which have same initial point. For example, this is vector P, this is vector Q, and this is vector R. In this case, these three vectors, that is vector P, vector Q, and vector R, have same initial point, that is O. So these vectors which have same initial point are known as co-initial vectors. Second one is collinear vectors. The vectors which act along the same line, for example, suppose this is line segment, this is vector A, and this is vector B, which is shorter in magnitude, but they both act along the same line, or the vectors which are parallel to each other, or the vectors which are anti-parallel to each other. Means for collinear vector, either vector should act along the same line, or they should be parallel to each other, or they should be anti-parallel to each other, then these vectors are known as collinear vectors. For example, in this case, the vector A, B, vector C, and vector D are collinear to each other. So they either act along same line or parallel or anti-parallel to each other, then they are known as collinear vectors. Next is coplanar vectors. Coplanar vectors, the vectors which lie in the same plane or which act in the same plane. For example, here we have three plane, plane XY, plane YZ, and plane XZ. Now suppose we have two vectors in this plane, this is vector A and this is vector B. Then vector A and B, as they lie in the same plane, they are known as coplanar vectors. Suppose we have one more vector, vector C, and that lie in the YZ plane. Now vector C is non-coplanar with vector A and B. It may be the case that if we draw another plane, for example, not XY plane or YZ plane or XZ plane, a plane such that in this way. So in this case, a vector A can be coplanar with a vector B since they lie in the same plane. So the vector which lie in the same plane are known as coplanar vectors, and the vectors which lie in different plane are non-coplanar. Suppose we have a plane such like that. In this format. Now a vector, if we draw a vector here, it seems that it is in the xy plane, but basically it is not in the xy plane, it is in this new plane, and this new plane is a way forward than xy plane. So here this vector, suppose this vector is d, this is not in the xy plane, so here vector a and d are not coplanar, they are non-coplanar vectors. Next one is free vectors. Free vectors, or also known as non-localized vectors. Are those vectors whose tail is not fixed. Means these vectors are free. We can move these vectors parallel to itself. Means suppose a vector is like in this way, then we can move this vector but only parallel to itself. Means we can move it forward, backward, downward and upward without changing its direction. Then these vectors are known as free vectors or non-localized. Vectors are basically a part of mathematics, and mathematics is language of physics. In physics, we have to study mathematics, especially algebra, trigonometry, geometry, vectors, and then calculus. The first three parts, that is algebra, trigonometry, and geometry, as you have covered in your previous classes, but now we will cover the vector part and later on calculus part. So vector. In vector, first thing is physical quantity. Physical quantity. Now any quantity that can be expressed in numbers or can be measured in units is known as physical quantities. Physical quantities are also known as mathematical objects. We have two type of physical quantities. First is scalar and second one is vector. Now, scalar are those physical quantities which have only magnitude but they don't have any direction. For example, number of apples in a basket, number of pen lines on a table, or time, mass, length, volume. So scalar quantities, the quantities that have only magnitude but no direction. For example, in terms of physical quantities, we have time, length, mass, volume, density, temperature, and so on. But in vector quantities, we have magnitude. That is, for vector quantities, magnitude as well as direction is necessary. Now, why we need vectors? Now, suppose you have to visit current, your current position here, that is at point O, and you have to visit your friend's house, and your friend tell you that his house is 5 km away from this point, that is from the position O. Now, without knowing direction, you can't reach your destination, because 5 km can be anywhere, that is 5 km, a radius of 5 km, and the destination can be anywhere on this circle. So we need magnitude, that is 5 km, plus a direction so that we can reach our destination. Means if Om is at point A, then we need a specific direction, that is in which direction we have to move. So vectors are those quantities we have which have magnitude as well as direction.